There are a ton of videos on YouTube about how to make $500 with photography, or start a photography business today, how to make money off your photography skill set. All great videos. A lot of them have some very valuable information, but I've noticed that there's one thing that these videos don't talk about, and that's what we're talking about today, how to protect yourself when you're making money with photography. Now, before we get started, I just want to say, if you're new to the channel, feel free to hit that subscribe button. I know you don't really know me yet, but you know, let's get to know each other. Let's become friends. And if you're already subscribed, welcome back. Let's jump into it, because this is super important and something that I learned firsthand that I want to pass on to you guys. Now, the reason I'm making this video is because this actually happened to me. I was stupid. I make mistakes, we all make mistakes, and I would like to pass on this information to you guys watching so that you don't make the same mistakes I do. If I can give you this info and you can carry it forward, hopefully you're in a situation where you know this before you learn the hard way like I did. Story time. So I was hired to do a project that involved photography, videography, and a magazine style brochure that used the photographs that I had taken to advertise the product. Now, when I get into the story, I'm not gonna mention any names or details, even though I should, because you know, the client wasn't a very nice person, but we'll keep that out of it and it'll be strictly informational for you guys. So I started the project, obviously, with the photo and video shooting on site, and it was very time sensitive. So the client's instruction to me was that the photos were the priority. If you could get those done ASAP, we'll have a little bit of time for the brochure and the video. So naturally, me being the nice guy that I am, I did the photos real quick, sent them over to the client, and had them review. I said, if there are any issues or you're unhappy with anything, let me know. Here's the mistake that I made that I don't want you guys to make in the future going forward. This is why I'm making the video. I did not collect 50% of what I was owed up front before the project started. In my head, I was referred to this person by someone I really like. I said to myself, hey, there's three parts to the project, and the first part being the photos is very time sensitive. So in good faith, I'll send the photos over, full resolution, unwatermarked, because of the time sensitivity. Again, my mistake. I'll send those over, and then I'll collect the 50% before I get started on the other work. Don't do that. My advice to you guys is that unless you're doing a job for your aunt or your uncle or a really close friend where you are 1,000 million, 100 billion percent sure they're gonna pay you, always, always collect 50% of what you are owed up front. And that 50% should essentially cover your time and your effort 100%, so that if you don't get that 50% that is due upon completion, you're still covered and you've still made some money. 50% up front, always. I learned the hard way. Let's move on with story time. So given that I didn't collect the 50%, I had sent the photos over to the person and I said, review them so I can get started on the brochure. If there's anything wrong with them, let me know. I assume that if you don't contact me saying, I don't like this, this is wrong, the photos are okay, you're happy with them. So I started on the brochure, which is the next step in the timeline. After completing a proof of the brochure, I had sent it over to the client with a watermark. Got my name plastered all over it. And I said to them, take a look at this. Let me know what you think. I've also sent over the invoice for the initial 50%. The other 50% will be due upon completion of the entire project. Things were looking good. Wrong. As soon as the client received the invoice for 50%, this person, as far as I can assume, didn't want to pay the amount that was owed, and then threw a hissy fit like a child. There were a lot of mean things said, completely unprofessional behavior, and essentially what this person said was, I'm unhappy with the way the brochure was designed. Okay, that's fair. Maybe you're not happy with what I did. The pictures are crap. They're unusable. I don't like them at all. I need to hire a new photographer to take all of these. Bear in mind that this person had a full week to tell me that something was wrong and chose not to do that until after the invoice was sent. Now here's where the story takes an actual fun, exciting turn, and I'm sure you guys will love hearing this. I reached out to the person and I said, hey, I understand that you're unhappy with the brochure. That's fine. I was not given very much instruction in terms of what you wanted it to look like, so I assumed and I did my own thing. If you're not happy with that, don't worry about it. Prior to this, the client mentioned that, quote, I'm not paying for any of this. You're not seeing a dime out of me because I don't like what I receive. There's gonna be situations where your clients may not be happy with what you're putting out, but Here's where I took exception to that. The person, regardless of the brochure, which they claimed was crap and I don't like it, etc., the person was using my photos for their project on the website. As soon as you're using someone's property, you've agreed that yes, you like this and this is something you're willing to pay for. However, this person then decided that they were unusable and only a percentage of the photos were good enough to be used. Whether you use all the photos I give you or one of the photos I give you, I have done what you hired me to do. So I said, listen, I understand you're unhappy. I will scrap the booklet. It's fine. You don't have to pay me for that. But I want to be compensated for the work that I've done in the photos, the time I spent shooting, the editing, and the fact that you're using the final product despite claiming you're unhappy. Now, I spent a good 9 hours back and forth with this person via email, phone call, contacting their boss, just to get the money I was owed for the photographs. In this time, I was treated very unprofessionally and, with no exaggeration, verbally abused. I was called things like a who can't and a and you know what? That's probably not a way to conduct yourself, but that's irrelevant to the fact that this can all be avoided. And these are the two things you guys will need going forward. Again, it was a nightmare and I want you guys to be protected from that. So learn from my mistakes. Now, prior to starting a project, what you're gonna wanna do is send your client an estimate. Outline in detail everything you're gonna provide. If it's a photo shoot, make it as clear as possible so that these people understand what they're paying for and what you're expected to do. You will get 20 edited photos. This includes 2 hours of shooting on location. Here are the charges for my transportation, gas. Here's an account maintenance fee of X amount. You set your pricing, but make sure your client knows exactly what is going to happen before you go on site. Once you get to the site, this is another thing you're gonna need, very important, it is a statement of work. There are plenty of examples you can find online of very good statements of work. And again, you have to outline what the client is getting, what you're doing, and then also use this statement of work to protect yourself. Include clauses like what happens if your equipment is damaged and it's not your fault, or if the person decides they are unhappy, or, you know, set the price breakdown, the terms and conditions on this statement of work so that the client has no excuse to say, I don't like this, I'm not paying you for that, blah, blah, blah. What you're gonna have them do at the end of all this on the bottom of the sheet is sign date, signature, client name, and then on the other side, your name, signature, and date. Once they've signed this, now you have some sort of paperwork to make it clear to them that you are owed a certain amount. In the event that they don't like your photos or whatever, they still have to give you the 50%. This is designed to make sure that you get paid for exactly what you're responsible for. And at the same time, your client will feel a little bit more at ease knowing that he's gonna do the 10 to 20 edited photos. He's gonna do this and that. So it gives you a little bit of accountability into what you have to deliver, but more importantly, it gives your client accountability in the fact that you can say, I gave you your 20 photos, you owe me my money. That's the end of discussion, because here it is in writing, you sign the document. Statement of work, very, very, muy, super importante. The other thing I mentioned briefly before is the 50% upfront. In certain cases, depending on the project, 50% of a project may not be reasonable. If you're working with something in the, you know, $200 to $500 range, most clients will be able to give you 50% upfront. Make sure you cover your butt that way. However, if you start working on projects that are in the tens of thousands, or, you know, you land a $50,000 contract, not a lot of people are gonna give you $25,000 upfront just for you to start working. So in that case, you would do something that you write into the statement of work, the amount of percentage that are due when? 25% upfront, okay? You need 25% of the total deposit before I start moving. Once I get on location and I take your pictures, after the pictures have been taken, that's another 25%. Once you have visual proofs, there's the third 25%, and then the final 25% is due upon completion. This way, as you're working, you're being compensated and you don't have to find yourself in a situation that I found myself in, and believe me, it sucks. The amount of headache I went through following that project just to get my money was definitely not worth the amount of money that I was paid at the end of the day, all of which could have been avoided by doing those two simple things, 50% up front and making sure you have a solid statement of work that is very clear in its outline of what is expected and the accountability your client has. As I mentioned before, there are plenty of great examples of, you know, estimates, statements of work, pricing breakdowns that you can find online. I really, really encourage anyone who's watching this and plans on making money off of their photography or videography, whatever trade or business you're in, if you're freelancing, if the money's coming directly to you, I very highly encourage you to do those things. Find good examples, make it your own, brand it, make it look nice. It makes you look super professional. It gives your client that idea that, whoa, this is not like some small-time dude working out of their basement. They're a big shot, they mean business. So you know what, I'm gonna sign it, I trust this person. So it makes your brand a little bit stronger. You're making money and you don't have to worry about the headaches that I have to worry about. If you guys found this useful, if you think that you learned something today, if you have any other tips or tricks that you guys use, shoot them down below. Make sure you hit that like button so, you know, other people know, hey, this is a good video. It's informative. He helped. And most importantly, hit that subscribe video so I can see you guys in the next one. Love ya.